you can now create a custom version of Google Gemini. Here's how. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and this Gemini Advanced tip is focused on how to use gems in Gemini. Let's go. So first things first, what are gems in Google Gemini? Gems are like your own personalized AI chatbot within Gemini. They are customized versions of Gemini tailored to your personal preferences that retain the specific characteristics that you assign. In short, gems are a way to create a more personalized experience in Gemini, very similar to custom GPTs in ChatGPT. So why would you ever use a gem? Gems are going to be really helpful if you find yourself writing the same prompts over and over again, and you can really streamline your workflow with them. Because gems retain set characteristics, you're not going to have to repeat your prompts to set the scene, if you will. The gem already has that baseline loaded, and you can focus on the exact information you need. You can create a gem for nearly anything you can think of. If you need help with recipes or writing specific code for something, maybe you need a personal travel planner or a writing assistant. You get the idea. And lucky for us, gems are really simple to set up and use. So here's how to use gems in Gemini.
Hello, hi. Brief interruption for you. I recorded what you're about to see a couple of months ago before gems were public.
What?
So you may notice along the way that there are a couple of things that are named a little bit different now. Don't worry, functionality remains the same. Where everything is laid out remains the exact same. I'll notate on screen for you the new naming conventions for certain buttons. You know Google loves a naming convention. So anyway, on with the show.
First, when you log into Gemini Advanced, you may see a new gem section in the left-hand menu. There are some handy preset gems for you to explore, like Adventure Builder, Brainstormer, Coding Helper, Cooking Partner, and even more. You can click on any of these to open up the gem, and you'll get a feel for how gems look and feel. So with this simplifier gem, you can provide a link, text, or topic, and the simplifier gem in Gemini will make it easy to understand no matter how complex. I'll click on one of these preset examples to show you how easy it is. And in about 2 seconds, I've got a really simple answer on what quantum mechanics is. This simplifier gem might as well be called Info for Noobs. It's great. But I really do love these pre-made gems. Not only are they a great way to help get you started and used to using gems, but they're also super helpful. So now let's create a gem from scratch. To create a new custom gem, click on Manage Gems from the left-hand menu. Any gems you create will appear here. So this is where you're going to edit any existing gems as well. To create a new gem, click on Create Gem. Here you can give your gem a name. So let's say I want a workout buddy. Or actually, maybe I want a personal trainer. I'm going to call this Tasia's Trainer. Now, here's where we need to give our gem instructions. We'll remember to give it a role. And if you want to know the importance of giving it a role and the proper way to prompt the LLM of your choice, you can watch that video by clicking up here or via the link in the description below. But back to our instructions. For gems, we're going to think more broadly than a specific task prompt. Instead, we're going to take into account the overall objectives and capabilities. So I'll say, I'd like you to act as a personal trainer who specializes in strength and conditioning. When I want to know about working out, gaining muscle, or increasing endurance, take into account that I work out at home 5 days a week, usually strength-based, for a minimum of 40 minutes per session. I take one active rest day and one rest day. I walk the dog daily for at least 20 minutes. You are knowledgeable, positive, and motivational in tone. And what's cool here is that as you're building your gem, you can test it out in this preview window to see how it's going to work. So now, since I want to test this out, here's where I'll write a specific prompt, if you will. I don't have to assign a role or repeat my workout schedule and where I do my workouts because all that information is already here. So now I can simply ask something like, how can I increase my weights on leg day to move up from 35 pounds to 50 pounds by the end of the year? And look at this. Well, this is quite helpful, isn't it? I am told about progressive overload and increasing about 5%, maybe every 1 to 2 weeks, which I definitely have not been doing. Listen to my body, of course. Then there's some info on exercise selection, like compound and isolated movements, some information on training structure, and so on. You get the idea. There's even nutrition info, which is really great. This is really quite detailed. So I'm happy with this gem overall. I think it's gonna produce good outcomes like this. So if you're happy on your gem, you're gonna click on create in the top right of that preview window. And your gem will be created from here. And we can start a chat, or if you close that out, you can always find your gem from that left-hand menu. So let's see a gem in action. I'll head to the Tasia's Trainer gem I created. Because that last prompt I did was just an example in preview, I'd like to recreate that here again so that I can keep my convos saved. So I'm gonna enter in essentially the same prompt. All right, so here's a similar but slightly different response, since you're never gonna get the same response twice, of course, but I just love this. And now, just like with any of our regular chats, this chat is saved and all of the info is retained, all tied to this gem. You're gonna be able to tell that a chat is tied to a gem in a couple of different ways. So first, in your saved chats in the left, when you hover over a chat, it'll show you that gem icon. So this leg day chat has this Tasia Trainer icon, just as this quantum mechanics example we saw earlier has the simplifier icon. Regular chats with Gemini will simply retain the chat icon. Plus, once you're in a chat, your responses will be provided by that gem, as opposed to seeing that Gemini logo in your responses. And you can keep your conversation or chat going for as long as you like with your gem. So I'll click back into this chat I created with my trainer gem. And this time I'm gonna ask about what I can use for resistance training because my band broke. And I'm not gonna give any more details. And just like that, because it has retained those initial instructions, which you may remember I said, I work out at home, it's given me a tailored response that includes things like household items and even furniture that I could use. But your gem can be used across multiple chats. So if I wanna keep that one chat about increasing my resistance and my weights for leg day, I can keep it focused to just that. And then as soon as I wanna create a new chat with the same gem, I'll simply click on that gem from the left-hand menu, and here it's gonna open a new chat for me. So here, maybe I'll focus this chat on my conditioning and endurance goals. And now I've got a separate chat still utilizing my trainer gem. And once again, because this gem has retained my specific instructions, it remembers that I work out at home, consistently walk the dog, and it's given me a plan specifically designed for me to build jump rope endurance. And then of course, I can keep this chat going as well if I'd like. And if you wanna know how to pin or retitle any chats in Gemini, I have a whole video that shows that feature and more, which you can watch by clicking up here or via the links in the description below. But remember, you can edit your gems at any time. To do so, you can hover over the gem and click the three-dot menu icon and select Edit, or alternatively, you can head to Manage Gems from the left-hand menu to edit and manage all of your gems. And here you can copy a gem, edit it, or even delete it if you no longer want it. So now that you know how to use gems in Gemini, it might be useful to think of some examples of helpful gems that can really help save you time. Besides all the helpful pre-made gems by Google, it could really be helpful to build a gem for maybe graphic design or even something specific like logo design. Or perhaps you want an admin assistant, or maybe you even want an email expert. Really think of the things that you use and need on a daily basis. You could build a gem for tutoring purposes or helping you with diagrams, or perhaps you need a book reviewer or a project manager. You get the idea. And as a bonus tip, remember, you can utilize your Gemini extensions when you're creating gems. And if you wanna know what the heck extensions are or all about how to use them, I've got an entire video on that for you. But let's say you're creating an administrative assistant gem. If you've got your Google Workspace apps or extensions linked in Gemini, you can add that as part of your instructions when you're creating that gem. So for this gem, I want to pull from my at Gmail, my at Drive, my at Docs, even my at Maps as needed. So now all of this information is baked right into this gem, and I can ask about specific docs in my Drive, and I don't have to give any more details. It's just gonna pull up that info from those sources directly for me. Gems are available now for Gemini Advanced users. So that's how to use gems in Gemini. Remember to explore all of the links in the description below for even more Gemini goodness. And now I want to hear from you. What do you think of gems in Gemini? Have you used them? Have you tried them? Do you want to? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like or share or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Gemini features. Thanks for watching. See you next time.